So, let's see here. I'll keep this open because I like to have it out because my cat sometimes would like to flip inside the case. And it gives me some sort of clue on how to read it a little bit better. If it has to be, if it's like a more intricate situation. Okay, so we got our music, and music has been blocking anything, so I'm like, okay, we're good to go. Now, TikTok's a whole different story for TikTok. I don't think I can have music actually playing in the background like that because it's actually full songs, and I have to go and basically kind of find a healing sound to go over everything in order for it to play. Like I said, I figure out ways how to go and not get muted. So, funniest thing ever is, you know what? Before I even start talking about the reading, right? I love grapes, okay? They're delicious. This has nothing to do with the reading. It's just something that I noticed. I was scared of the black grapes because I'm like, where the hell did a black grape come from? I've never heard of a black grape before. These aren't fucking black. They're called black grapes, but they're fucking purple. They're dark purple. They're not black by any means. Even the stem, the vine itself, has a hue of purple on it. I don't know if it can be seen, but it's a hue of purple on the vine. And I'm just like, they taste. They're much sweeter than the red ones. The red ones are sweet with a little bit of a tartness to them. The green ones are just, you know, they taste like regular grapes. They're not really that sweet, but they're not really tart either. It's kind of a real balance where towards it's just like, it is, but it's not. And those black ones, they're just, like, they're purple. I'm like, these guys are fucking purple. Like, why do they think they're black grapes? They're purple. Anyway, I still like the red ones better. The first time I had the red ones were maybe about a month or two ago. But anyway, let's get back to the reading. Train. Somebody might be getting on a train. Somebody could be traveling by train. I'm getting, okay? And this one is Soul Sister. Maybe somebody's looking for their soul, kindred spirit. You know, their soul. This is Soul Sister, the name of the song. So I'm thinking of a kindred spirit, soulmate, you know, stuff like that. People are looking for or probably trying to figure out exactly who in their circle, if anybody at all, is something like that. It's no secret. Basically, we are everybody that is around us, and everybody is a version of ourselves. So, you are always surrounded by your own company. It's just in a frequency that you either are or you're not in or you used to be in, or something that you just don't vibrate at all. You probably wouldn't even interact with them, so they'll just be, you know, another stranger on the street or what have you. But yeah, we are in everybody around us. So that's why it's just like, hey, yeah. Treat people the way you would like to be treated, right? There's a reason for that. It's not just because it's the right thing to do. It's because you're literally interacting with yourself on a daily basis. Okay? And that's what people don't understand. We are connected in more ways than it's believed. Also, earlier, throughout the whole entire day, I've also been getting a pull about something coming out of the sea, something coming from the ocean, something's in the ocean, Mariana Trench. You know, we have not really explored a lot of anything, and it's I actually turned on the Pluto last night. I don't know why. It's random times I'll just turn it on because I really don't watch TV at all. I really don't. I'll turn on YouTube or something. I'll watch documentaries. I'll watch some, you know, the music videos. If, you know, I got a playlist on there or something, then, you know, I'm watching the videos on there. You know, I look at multiple different things, and Pluto was something that I was just like, okay, well, if I'm listening to this, I'll turn on Pluto and have it playing through my speaker. And, Leviathan was on, and I'm like, wow, I remember I had the dream about the Leviathan, and it was attacking all the humans that were in the water. This huge monstrous thing just freaking bit the head off, I think it was me. The thing is, we think that we're so advanced and everything now, when you have no clue exactly what the past has actually been through or came up with, because everything was like built up and destroyed, just like it is every go around. But yeah, the dream about the Leviathan that I actually had, I believe that it was showing, I was working, and it was a station. It was a station that went from the floor to the surface. But the thing is, it ran through a few of the co-workers that I was with, that was on the floor with me, and before it came to me and took my head. Just like when I was shot in the backseat of a cop car, and the one where the spirit left the body, I was looking around, and I didn't know that I was gone until I looked and I see my body slumped over. And that's when I was able to get over the shock, leave out the car, and finish watching the fire that was happening, that was going on. It was a setup. The same thing happened with the dream of the Leviathan. It was the it was a thing of afterwards I was able to, I guess, appear inside the station that I was working in, and everybody was notified of what happened, and, you know, it was an emergency evacuation and everything else. But then I woke up. So, yeah. And then, get this. So I'm being pulled to talk about, you know, being pulled to talk about, but basically I was being pulled to just sit here and start, you know, telling you guys, you know, I'm getting a feeling about something that's in the water. There's something in the fucking water. There's something in the water. They're not telling me. There's something in the fucking water. And it's coming. Oh, man. Yeah. It's coming. something to be erupting from the water. Something will be erupting from the water. Things that we don't know about. So yeah. What to expect? I don't know. But that's what it feels like, you know, being talking about the Mariana Trench and everything. Okay, and then all of a sudden, when I start watching, you know, my little videos and stuff, and you know, all my work and everything, I keep on getting all this freaking. I'm like, what the hell? I'm trying to fold clothes. I'm trying to, you know, straighten up. I'm like, what is going on? Why am I being? What is going on with the Mariana Trench? What is going on with the ocean? What is going on with the fucking water? What is in the fucking water? Like, why is this coming to me? And then it's just like, oh, okay. This little short just popped up where the dude is like, they put a tracker on these sharks and they followed them, okay? And they followed this one great white shark. I gotta get the name of the person, and hopefully I come across it again. But basically, they follow these great white sharks, they tag them, okay? And the thing was following the great white shark that went all the way out into the middle of the ocean, right? The shark name is Caroline. And she's a great white shark. She swam at like 5 something in the morning all the way out into like the middle of the ocean, right? Off of the East Coast, okay? And then, like, not too much longer later, you know, she really swam super fast back inland and then back out again. And they're like, they don't swim that fast. Like, the only thing that's, you know, able to move that fast and everything is the Meg. And you remember they said that the Meg is extinct. But then, too, they show you everything before shit happens here. And they like to recreate shit here. They recreated dinosaurs. They recreated a lot of things that went extinct or that were in danger of going extinct. You know? Genetically modified. Think about Deep Blue Sea, how they had the sharks and they did something with the brains and everything, and next thing you know, they're like, I don't want to say cyborgish, but cyborgish, okay, because, you know, they were operating with, they were programmed, okay, and then the sharks were having offspring and everything, so it was just like, and then we get the movie The Meg. Okay, and like I already feel as though there's this huge, giant, freaking Leviathan type of serpent in the freaking ocean that's going to pop up. I mean, you don't know what's in the ocean. You can't say that it is or that it isn't. You really can't. But what type of shark is moving that fast? Unless something ate the shark and then started going back and forth. And some people actually said that too in the thing. Well, it was eight, you know, something bigger ate it and, you know, started swimming around. So it's just like, Now, does anybody else remember the buoy off of the East Coast that went off out of nowhere? Like it was going to be some, you know, either huge tsunami type of thing, or like something was dragging it really fast or something. But this was like a couple years back. I can't remember if it was before my injury or after it, so give or take 7 years, you know. I'm not really sure, because, you know, yes, after I got hurt, shit was just like hit and miss with time. But I'm like, okay, that's enough. Alright, so it's time to shuffle. Let's get into this. Um, see what we're going to be talking about today. No workout today. I worked my ass out in the house and cleaned up and folded my clothes. And that's about it. Study some stuff. Study. Gotta always move it, always go. We have communication coming in. Page of Swords. Communication. Okay. Swift messages. Three of Swords. Crossing Three of Swords about an ending. With the Three of Swords crossing this Page of Swords, I'm getting a swift communication of an ending. There's an ending coming. A message of an ending that has come, like, suddenly, damn near. Okay. The Chariot. Forward movement. Now, always remember that, yeah, the Chariot is forward movement, but it's also a battle card, so something might actually be some sort of a ordeal, okay, to deal with. But then too, it could just be forward movement. As in, you know, moving past the situation at hand. Okay. Maybe somebody's moving forward into a marriage. Like the last song was Girl on Fire, so somebody could have been heated about something. Something could have ended. Somebody, you know, could have just been driven in fiery passion and could be heading off into marriage. Take it as it resonates. Knight of Cups. Yeah, somebody has been offering, giving, making offers and giving into a situation. Okay. This situation. That's right. Yeah, y'all are just flipping out. Four of Swords crossing over this. Okay, somebody is putting an ending to this Knight of Cups energy. Okay, because the Knight of Cups energy, like I said, is crossing over just like this. Okay, and I think this may be a... This could be one of the messages, you know. Somebody is done with being in a Knight of Cups energy and just, you know, coming in, giving, and being flighty and all the other stuff. Or they could just be ending that Knight of Cups energy, taking however it resonates with you. Like I said, these are certain endings that are coming, and then there's forward movement also on the board. There's not just one energy here. There's two different things going on. But it's all kind of like resonating the same. Like I said, we're all dealing with ourselves on a daily basis, okay? Different versions of ourselves in different timelines, in different situations, different frequencies, different vibrations. And it's like a lot of this stuff can intersect with each other and not be the same energy. It's crazy how that shit happens, but it happens like that. Double-ish energy in the reverse. The devil is in reverse. Okay, so somebody, like I said, somebody's trying to put a stop to, okay, they were given into a situation. Okay, but it, you know, it's flighty. I'm looking at, you know, the horse is hesitant to cross over. Okay? And this is like, hesitant type of energy, like you're hesitant, you're should I stay, should I go type of thing going on. And this is crossing over the sport, so this situation is coming to an end. And you know, the devil's in reverse, so this could have been, you know, somebody who was very indecisive, you know, can't make up their mind or anything. They're putting an end to that. Okay, we have a Queen of Pentacles and we have the Nine of Pentacles energy. Okay, putting an end to this situation. Okay. Queen of Pentacles, Nine of Pentacles. Two separate energies, two different energies. Okay. Okay, so there's a Queen of Pentacles and there is a, there's a Nine of Pentacles energy too. Either this could be two counterparts, okay? Or towards somebody is in there, you know, Nine of Pentacles. They're, you know, on the brink of fulfillment. They have everything they could ever want and need. All they need is that, you well, not need, but, you know, the one thing that will push them over the top is, you know, having a partner in crime, basically. You know, that ride or die buddy, the forever your best friend, you know, a partner, you know, somebody they can trust. And we have the Queen of Pentacles here, so maybe a Queen of Pentacles is trying to make an offer to a Nine of Pentacles energy over here, or maybe a Nine of Pentacles energy is looking at a Queen of Pentacles over here and, you know, are trying to get a little bit closer. Okay, this could be something going on. Or somebody's looking to make somebody that is sitting in a Nine of Pentacles energy into their Queen of Pentacles. Take it however it resonates. Like I said, that song that just came on, that could actually be another one to look at. Yeah, so this Nine of Pentacles energy is like they already walked through their gateway, you know. They got their messages, they're happy, they're fulfilled, they're sitting with their, you know, grapevines and pentacles. They got their nature surroundings, their messages coming in. They're golden, you know, in the sun, just relaxing, enjoying life. Okay, and they're in the upright, they're not being slowed down, they're just going for what they want. They're in their fucking energy, okay? Okay. What else is going on in this world? Alright. Five of Wands in the reverse. Something is being sent back. Oh, okay. So we have the Five of Wands in the reverse, and we have the Ten of Pentacles as fulfillment. Something backfired, has been returned, okay? Something is being returned onto a group of people, okay? Maybe that's what this message was about. For, you know, some things, like I said, the whole entire start off is about swift communication about some endings, okay? And like I said, there's a lot of energies in my book, so this is another one that just popped out. And we have 5 of Wands in the reverse, along with the 10 of Pentacles in the upright. So something was destined to backfire on a bunch of bitches. They hot. And along with this situation, we have the 8 of Wands, okay, crossing over the situation. This is a backfire, just like I said. Oh, wait, you can see it. Yay. Okay. Yeah, this is a backfire situation right here, the one that just popped out. And what planted things down? Ooh. Somebody was doing spell work. This the 3 of Pentacles. The three of wands. They walked into a manifestation. When you're walking into a manifestation, it's a manifestation that you created for yourself. This was a backfire. Ooh, shit. Knight of Swords. Very fast acting, fast moving energy. This came up in the upright. Okay, so this was caused by a Knight of Swords energy. Somebody was walking around, okay, with no information. No facts. They were just harsh for no reason. They were harsh, moving, fast acting with no reason in this situation. That's why everything backfired. I don't know if I should read this or not because they were just on the top of the damn thing. Alright, look. I'm going to put you guys in the middle. Because however it's supposed to come out, it's going to come out. Alright. What else? What the situation? Or period. Like, seriously. I know what you guys. What else do we have coming out? This was in the upright. This was sideways. Okay, and what we had... Oh, somebody is trying to keep somebody... A Queen of Cups energy trapped. Okay? Queen of Cups energy. Somebody's trying to keep somebody in an energy of entrapment, but giving still. These individuals are probably, you know, not sleeping and overindulging. I mean, there's nothing wrong with whatever you do. Shit. We all do our little shit here and there and everything, but I think somebody's trying to keep somebody in overindulgence to the point of trying to get them to overdose and either overdose or overindulge in some sort of, you know, toxic energy. This way they can stay trapped. They want somebody to stay trapped. Somebody, this Queen of Cups is a very giving individual, very nurturing, motherly, and somebody is trying to keep them locked up and put away. That's why I landed inside the thing. Like I said, hey, yeah, I have to keep this out because it lets me know how to, you know, read the energy around the card if it doesn't need to be on the board. Itchy. Okay. Let me hurry up. Ten of Swords. Crossing over. Trying to keep them trapped. Having trouble stabbing them in the back. Like, but they were successful in the past with doing this to this energy. They were very successful. That's why they're used to keeping them in this type of a closed off type of a situation, energy, okay? But they're having trouble. It's not coming out in the upright. It's just sliding. It's just missing. Totally missing. They're not able to do what they did before. The Hierophant. The Hierophant. And the Ace of Pentacles is separate from all this shit. Okay, so the Hierophant is crossing over the Ace of Pentacles, which is divine guidance and blessings. Something gifted from the above is coming down. Earth angel energy. Yeah, gifted from above. Earth angel traditional. Knowledgeable guidance. Anything else, because we are running low on time. Got about 5 minutes left. Ooh. Okay. Alright, so like I said, this Hierophant and is crossing the Ace of Pentacles, okay? And this is basically gifted from above. Coming down, Earth Angel type of energy. This is guidance. This is a gift from above, from Source. And it is guidance crossing all over this gift. And the guidance that is down, we have third party energy in the reverse on top of the deck, okay? And since this is what came out, this happened to an energy, to the Hierophant energy. Somebody's walking around. And they were sitting here. Plotting. This Three of Cups is in the reverse. This could have been some sort of a group action towards his energy up here. Okay, they're reaping what they sown with the Seven of Pentacles in the reverse. Okay, they were sitting. They're reaping what the fuck they sow. They played over an energy that was nothing but guidance. Okay. Hey man, in the reverse. They are stuck. Page of Pentacles in the reverse. False offerings. Okay. Three of Cups in the reverse, along with the Page of Pentacles in the reverse. This was a group activity. Messages coming in or advice, you know, well, advice is like messages anyway. But all this stuff was coming in towards this energy that was falsified, okay? There was no truth within this group that was acting against this individual up here or these individuals. But I'm telling you, with the Seven of Pentacles in the reverse, they thought they were going to harvest something. But in turn, you know, time came and what they thought they were going to harvest, they ended up reaping. They reaped what they sown. They did something in the past. They're reaping what they sow now. They're stuck in their heads and they're wondering what the hell is going on with the Hangman in the reverse. This is not enlightenment because it's in the reverse, okay? This fucker here, they don't know what the hell is going on. They don't know what the hell happened. They don't know where the fuck up happened. You fucked up when you fucked the wrong person. That's what happened. So, they played with spell work. They went against somebody. Shit backfired in this energy over here and on these people over here and in a lot of these other situations as well. And we do have two counterparts that are trying to come together. And like I said, I am not really going over the whole entire reading again because I've been going through it the whole entire time. And plus, it's time to, you know, cut the camera off because it's about to end. And hopefully, you know, this is like making sense to somebody. Take whatever resonates with you and leave the rest, because not everything is for everybody. There are a bunch of different situations, and that's all she wrote, you know. But yeah, so you know, be mindful of the company that you keep. You know, some people just want to sit here and watch you, you know,